go time.
Well, this one's like.
Hey, don't be afraid to share your file with people if they need it in Starline, no?
The new technology.
Of 1,000, you should straight have like just like a
scroll.
No, I'm talking like now, like huge, just like you're flipping through notes.
Normally this
big out, like the fold out map.
Normally this, we have a lot more notes than this, but we only had 2 weeks to do it, so this is what we came up with. It's not bad.
Take care of my Tacoma. It's my Idaho farm truck. So I said, so we shouldn't have used drywall screws through the cab to mount the Starfleet?
We thought it was a beater.
Yeah, we thought it was one of your Mexico beaters.
So you guys, you gotta text them and say, that Starlink looks pretty bitchin' on the cab of the truck. That's pretty high tech for a Tacoma.
Racing here, we're not going to the Las Vegas buffets, bro. Right.
Bro, you ever try to drive a race car for 8 hours?
Yeah.
It works you out. You're hungry.
Bro, look at me. You're like skin and bones, bro.
That's what I'm saying. I burn off all my food. You got plenty to feast on.
Yeah, I can go like 3 days, dude.
Your body's in there like, oh, let's dig into this. Mine's like, well, we got bone or cartilage. What are we eating today?
To hear about it.
117 and Jamal. Straight up.
Who are you visiting?
Jamal.
No corners of power. Terror breeze. Touching the All right, yeah, so just wrapped up the Baja 400, and man, that was a tough race, man. It was so many different variables. I'm stoked to be here, though. Started off the race really good, just kind of cruising, hit my marks. Got a really random flat, just out of nowhere, got a flat. Luckily, we had to chase guys real close. They were able to change it, but lost a lot of track position, and just kind of put my head down and started charging and just hitting my marks and tried to make no mistakes from here on out. So, and then around race mile 250, 260, I caught Hancock. He was leading, I was in second, and was just trying to catch him running hard, and the dust was just insane. It was, we couldn't see. Me and Andrew, Drew was hitting his marks like crazy. I honestly don't know how we made it through. Like, we were running full race pace, blind, completely blind. Because we would like try something, they would gap us, and then we would run through their dust, catch them in the dust, like be on their bumper trying to figure out. Like, it was pretty intense. So I'm stoked like the truck's in one piece. It's so tough because we could see them. They're right there, but we just couldn't push through their dust because it was so technical. But yeah, and then like, I don't know, pretty close to the finish, there's these big rollers and we were kind of just in some dust, and I just missed time one and just straight stuffed the bumper and ripped it off. And I thought I broke the steering. So we were like panicking. I'm like, dude, you gotta be kidding me. And then luckily I was like, it went away. So I think the bumper bent down and we kind of just kept cruising, and now we're here. So I'm stoked, you know, the whole team, Optima Batteries, Andrew and I had a tough day, and he stuck by my side the whole day. So I'm stoked to be here. Optima Batteries, Ford Performance Raptor is so much fun to drive, and we're gonna learn from it and go back and come swinging at the 1,000. Perfect starting position, and I think the cards will play out in our favor. Dude, it's not official yet, so I hate to get too wild, but feeling pretty confident. Ah, dude, I'm. It was a tough day, so that makes it like normally, like yeah, he missed a VCP, which that's racing, and like we make sure we hit every VCP, but like today, after spending so much time in his dust, man, it's true.